Welcome back to my channel. This is the 360 Traveler, and maybe it's a bit hard to listen to me properly, but you know what, this is the fourth video today, and if you've seen the previous video, you might have noticed, if you've seen it until the end, and if you haven't, just check it until the end. It ends at Marina Bay Sands, where I took my video of the Apple Store. And basically, I didn't take the bumper of this vertical battery thing when I used the Insta360 ONE R with the vertical battery. So what happened is that, well, the worst thing that can happen, that, you know, you could think that would happen with such a camera, it's just, I was riding pretty slow, and that's what really saved kind of the camera, because it just fell apart, because I didn't take the bumper. Now I took a piece of tape with me, I took some tape with me, thanks God. Anyway, I just wanted to show you that, guys. And I just roll some tape around it, because I didn't take the bumper, the thingy that keeps these three pieces together. Oh shit, that was... Thanks God I have the tape that keeps it together. So I just wanted to show you this by night. And I was like, okay, I'm not gonna make this full video today, because it's gonna be a full video, and who wants to make a full video? You know, I've taken like too many videos already. But whatever, I mean, like, I'm pissed off at myself. I'm a bit sad right now, because, yeah, as you can see, if you look on my side, on one of the corner, anyway, you're gonna be able to see it very clearly. Well, this time it's not some drop of water, whatever, because there was a lot of that. I don't really care about getting rid of the water and whatever, and I don't take it out normally. So if I don't take it out normally, I shouldn't be so worried and sad about this happening now. Well, it just got scratched. The thing is that because I was going pretty slowly, so it didn't get scratched very much. So luckily only one side got scratched, so the other side is still completely clear. I can choose which side is gonna look at what, either at myself or at... Actually, right now it's looking this way. If I turn it like that, maybe... I don't even look at myself here. Maybe if I turn it like that, I don't know if it's gonna be more in a frame or more. Every time I want, there's something I don't specifically, I don't want to speak, film something specifically. I mean, I don't, it's the least beautiful thing in the scenery I'm filming, then it's gonna have to point the scratch that I've made now on my camera. I mean, I'm a very absent-minded person, and it pisses me off, because I never dropped the Samsung Gear 360, which I use quite a lot. I never dropped this one until now, which I haven't used that much, but I mean, clearly that was going to happen. And I have the bumper, because they sell the vertical battery separately. They should sell it together, no matter what, because people need it. They need the bumper, because in this specific situation, okay, if I was holding it in my hand and just filming like that, then maybe, yeah, you don't need a bumper, because it's going to be a little hard for the parts to get apart. But in this situation, obviously, when your bicycle is bumping on things and stuff, that was a stupid idea of me. Think that you just stay in place, that would just remain in place, and that you just not get dislocated, you not just fell apart. That was so stupid of me and reckless. And I feel mad now at myself and shit, because if I need to replace this fucking lens, it's gonna be like, what, 200-300 Singapore dollars? You know, and just for people watching this video, it's not having to cope with that. Even if it's not very much of a scratch, it's still a scratch, and I've taken a small video checking out if I could see the scratch once I had taken the video, but I could even see it on the screen. I could even see it when I was taking a selfie. I could see it, so that, and now I keep on doing it, and I'm like, how long has it been? So I should have 9 minutes left, okay. Anyway, so you get to see that by 9, and this one I'm gonna have to make a noise reduction. This is gonna even take longer to export, because it's a beautiful sight. I mean, I was like thinking, should I take this full video or I shouldn't? And really, I should, yeah. And I'm happy that I'm doing it now, because, yeah, it's amazing. But yeah, once again, the scratch side is here. This is the non-scratch side. And now I'm thinking, okay, you know what? I'm gonna, on the long run, maybe it's not such a bad thing, because imagine if I lose it somewhere, I scratch it, I damage it, it's not working. When I'm traveling and there's no way I can replace it wherever the hell I can be, and I still want to film 360 videos, then here Singapore is a good place actually to get a second lens, 360 lens, get a second 360 whatever, so that I still have my Samsung Gear 360 if worst case scenario, also if I had to, but it's not going to be as good as that. So now the thing is that maybe it's a bad thing for a good thing. As you say in French, it's a mal pour un bien, because maybe then, okay, right now it won't happen, but in a while I might just buy a replacement, so I could use the replacement, and if I get more adventurous with my camera and I drop the other one and it gets really scratched and fucked and I'm somewhere where it's going to be hard to get a replacement anyway, I will always have this lens on the side. I always have kept this lens and I can always use it. I'm just curious now to check out the footage, really, to see how bad it is. Because it's kind of usable, because I know that whenever there's a drop, and it's just a matter of like drops, it's pretty visible, and then I'm like, oh, I should have cleaned my lens rather than just like lap drops, and then like you can see like half of the scene because there's a couple of drops on the camera on Insta 360 1R. But now it's a little scratched. It's a little scratch, but it's pretty apparent on the video. So now the thing is, like, hopefully I'm not gonna drop it again and stuff. And the thing is, like, I was just lazy to care about putting the bumper. Getting dark, and I'm ready to go home by night, but basically that's what we're gonna get here. I'm gonna have to go back by night, yeah. So yeah, here we go. here. By the way, I'm just showing you this beautiful view by night. And hey, people have just cycled so fast. My pedal is like, it's a bit weird, it's making some weird sound now. So, yeah. This is what it is. So when I put it on the side like that, I don't know how it looks like. And they do. So when I put it back like that, and if I put it only like that, it could just drop off like some. What about if I just turn it like that? You know, either way, it's gonna be a little tricky because. It's still gonna be there. No matter what, it's still gonna be in the middle of these plants. And you can't find it. That's a good thing. Take into consideration. Kind of like gaining weight now that I don't go to the gym, and lately when I was not going to the gym in the evening, I would just skip my dinner. But now I'm like, oh, I'm on keto, so I don't have to do it anymore. I don't have to skip it. I'm not gonna get fat anyway. Now I'm thinking, actually, well, it's not I'm thinking, it's like I've taken my measurement and I've gained like a bit of waist here, only like half or 1 centimeter after I lost it. So because although I've been eating like keto only, I've been eating quite a lot lately, and maybe that's one reason why gaining back maybe about 1 kilogram. So let's say you want to film on this side. Okay, I want to film on this side. And here you can see from the front this one. I'm going upside down. I'm going back now. And I have a few minutes to film. I want you to have a real good look at how nice this is. I like this camera, but one thing I'm impressed about it is the, well, the low light performances. It's not really that amazing, so at least you get to see like this beautiful view just when it's getting dark, right after the sunset. And, so what I can check though is like how long. Okay, I got 1 minute left. So guys, I'm gonna shoot you a little there, but anyway, thanks for watching. That was the this video. I'm not going to actually see it. This is a 360 traveler. Here we go. This is a 360 traveler, aka Leon the digital nomad as well. Other YouTube channel. You can have a bit of review. It's gonna finish in a few seconds, but yeah. To upload these videos, it's gonna be hard, but it's gonna be this next couple of days. 4th of October, 2020 today, and yeah, you've been watching.